Welcome back everyone to Finnegan's Farm. Welcome back to our YouTube channel and to our workshop Wednesdays. In today's video we have the 6910 in. We had a few little issues there with the starter on it. Sometimes it would start and sometimes it wouldn't start. So Sean has taken off the starter here. Big job?
No, not major. Now there's only a nut on the top, bolt on the bottom. Release your two cables and your little tiny, see the small little one there into your solenoid as well. Just release them and also make sure to release your battery at the very start and pull it out straight away then.
Right, okay. So we brought the starter into Navan Auto Electrical there to just get reconditioned, and we actually have it back there. We have it over on the bench here. So we're just going to show you actually what happens, the workings of a starter, because most people will just turn the key and the tractor will start. So we'll bring it on over now. So we have the starter here on the bench there. We just put it on the vise just to clamp it there. We have our battery pack just to set up as acting as our battery really. Mm-hmm. And Sean has a little push button here. Ignition just to activate exactly what you would be doing with the key.
Yeah.
So the purpose of the starter, Sean?
The purpose of the starter is to turn your flywheel to get your crankshaft going in your engine, to start your valves and the whole lot, and then that's what then gets your exhaust and your spark. Yeah. So
this gear here should, when we engage it here, this should spin out and it should turn at a very high speed, and this will engage with the ring gear, and that's what in turn starts your tractor, we'll see on the flywheel. So if you want to, just for a demonstration there, Sean, hit the...
Yep.
So as you can see here, the starter will pop out, the gear will go out, the small gear will go out, hit it again, Sean, and it'll spin at a very high speed. So when we got reconditioned, well, the Bendix here was given, he says a lot of them give problems here,
yeah,
and they changed that, and he also changed putting new gear on it here, because these intend to get worn, especially at the face of them here where they're engaging with the ring gear there. So he put a new gear on it here, a new Bendix. I think it cost around €100 to get reconditioned, so it just, the way it was going on, it was only going to get worse, it was never going to get better anyway. So we replaced that on the 6910. So we're going to pop that one back in as well. Sean will stick it back in there. You might see him there on the video sticking it back in. So we also have one of the Tailift Forklifts in here, the 3.5 ton Tailift Forklifts. There's about 10 forklifts here on site on the farm anyway, between battery operated ones and diesel powered ones. So these are the big arc diesel powered ones there that do all the big lifting there. To lift up maybe 7 meters there with the boxes there as well. So what we try to do is we bring them in, we have a little checklist here that we go through, we write it out. We're going to get all this set up on the computer there, that we can actually print off a checklist there. So when we bring it in, we will have the name of the forklift and all the different things we have to point out, because if it was an electric forklift, obviously there'd be things would apply to this forklift that wouldn't apply to an electric one. So really what we try to go through here is lights is an obvious one. Make sure that all the lights are working there, especially for the guys stacking the boxes in the fridges there, that they have plenty of good light. The LED lights are very popular now, and they don't take a whole lot of power to run them, so
No, great job.
Yeah, they're not hard on a battery or anything like that. Indicators, we just check them. Obviously, their turn left or right wouldn't be a main thing to be doing, but wipers there is another very important one, that they have very good wipers there on between front and rear there, so they can see where they're going, and we keep the wipers good on them. The horn is always a hot important one, so if they meet other forklifts, we'll say within the packhouse that they have some sort of a signal that they can say, well, I'm coming around the corner, or I have a box on board, or generally just to have it. Your flasher then to be seen there. Dark evening there, at half four it gets dark there now, so they're coming in and out constantly, in and out of the fridges there and the packhouse there, so they need to have it. Then we're down to, we'll say, the engine side of things. We have oil level, air filter, coolant level. These are fairly standard things, aren't they, Sean?
Yeah, lads should be doing them in around once a week, definitely. Oil level once a day, air filters and coolant once a week is usually the general practice.
So we kind of rely on the drivers to some degree to get some of the engine and the maintenance and that. They'll do that themselves. But then there is other things that we need to check when we get back into the workshop. Obviously the mass, the grease is there, check the rollers. Tire pressure as well, or not tire pressure, because these are semi-solids, but just the condition of the tire here, that they don't start getting slicks on them here, because then the car, a lot of spinning goes on then, and you know, they lose a lot of grip, and you know, they can have a lot of, we'll say, they can be putting their accelerator down and going nowhere, like, so they should always have a good grip. You can get them re-threaded and re-grooved there on that. Wheels, always wheel nuts, especially front wheel nuts there, where you have maybe two boxes hanging out, 2.5 ton hanging out of the mast here.
Yeah.
And we have seen instances there where
have become wobbly and loose.
The wheel nuts have got loose. So you need to be looking at them. Lever bushings too. While it might seem the one that will get the most use there is always the up and down. And you'll see in this one here, we have a little bit of play in it before it does the actuation. So it's actually there before it actually will let it down. So sometimes what can happen is when they get really loose, they can cross over onto these, and then, you know, that cause. Levers are still, we have one or two there on little solenoids there on the electrics, but the levers are still very basic and they work. The weather doesn't really affect them either there, where it can, we'll say, on the electronic ones there, but this one here is there. So we have a little bit of wear, so we'll note that and maybe replace the bushings in that or have it in for the next day. So we're really doing an appraisal here on the forklift when we have it in, and we can fix on here today, we'll be fixed, and anything then will be noted for the next day. Where else are we down here? Steering, even the rotator there and the steering, this little steering knob, you can see it here too, a little bit of wear coming into it. And it mightn't seem a big thing, but I've seen these where they'll actually pinch your hand there when you're turning with them. So we replace that as well, putting a unit of them on it.
Yep.
And that's just from pure wear and tear. What else have we here? Handbrake check, very important one.
Yep.
Brakes, obviously very important as well. Door hinges and locks. Yeah. Again, another one.
Something so, we find the lads talking about the whole time, something so small but so important, you know.
Yeah, so they need to be shut nice. That's a nice shut there, nice, and it's easy to open there. Plus that the rams are good, the pneumatic rams are good there, that the door stays open, because if you get a bad ram and it goes over and you get the wind, gust of wind, then next minute it's a pile of glass on the ground. So we don't want that anyway. Just to avoid anything like that. So we door hinges, door struts. The condition of the seat is always another one there.
Yeah.
We want to keep the seats always fairly good in them.
Sliding forward and back and that.
Yeah, and make sure that they're sliding forward and back. Now, most of these will have their own operator.
Yeah.
Generally tend to be in them, but if you have a forklift that maybe has three or four operators, one lad to be long and one lad to be short, so they need to be able to move the seat up and down. Close to the seatbelts are always working now. They do, they're there. I don't know how many of them wear them, but they're on them anyway.
Absolutely.
Forks wear then. The fork wear is generally the back of the fork is really where we look for wear.
The heel.
You can see that on the heel of the fork. That one, those two forks they look like new forks, but it looks in there anyway, so there's no wear on that. So we can only determine, we'll put a percentage wear as a report when we put it in the computer, and the next day then we'll have another look. So some of them will have all wear, and when they get down to such a point then we just have to replace them.
Yeah.
Your back axle, yeah?
Yeah, making sure there's three grease points, I think, on both sides, just for your bushings and bearings when you're pulling, it'll swing out the wheel there. But have a look. See, our main grease points is one, two, and there's three, there's a fourth one in behind there when you lock out the other way. So so you see there, there's four grease nipples. They're very important, you know, the life of the back axle there.
Yeah,
you know?
So we've done back axles, back axle bushings, and then in general tear, another one then is probably the heater there to make sure that when you turn the key on, the heater ignites so that they're not constantly turning, which will end up in maybe something happening in the starter or wherever it is anyway. So, yeah, well, that's the factors in general. They don't look as if there's much to be done to them, but I can tell you there's always plenty to be done in the factors.
Absolutely, yeah.
Because they put up serious hours during the year, probably more than any engine around here. The factors are the ones that people kind of sometimes pay least attention to, but we like to take a lot of attention and a lot of looking after them there. We do get them back into the workshop anyway. So that's the fact. We also had Kaylem Russell there. Kaylem came up there on Saturday there to do a little bit of work with me there. We were working actually on the cabs there on the 3650s. He also hopped in with Cathal there and he got a quick haircut there as well. So you'll see that on the video there. So he's looking sharp there, wasn't he?
Absolutely.
Welcome back to Workshop Wednesday and we've a surprise visitor in.
Yeah.
Kaylem Russell back from the dead.
I said I'd give the lend me magic wand here for an hour evening.
Didn't even come to work. He came for a haircut.
The fact I'm after driving the whole way from Waterford up here now just for a haircut.
Exactly.
You must be good, hey?
That's it. So how are you getting on anyway?
Oh, you're flying.
Living the life more like.
Oh, sure.
From the Snapchats I see anyway.
Sure, maybe I am. Wouldn't just get that far now, but learning my trade anyways.
That's it.
Slowly.
There he goes. Out the gap. Look at that.
Oh, fuck it.
Ready for work in the morning.
Yeah, wood's out, but you're up and
so we also, Tom Miller there, one of the workers there, was he drives the 470. Tom brought it in there, he washed it, oiled it up and put it away in the shed. So you can see Tom there just getting it all cleaned up there. It takes great attention to detail, we'd say, with any of them in machines. And the fairness from there, he had the 470 looking well going away. So great job there. We also had the guys from Autosmart that called in as well. Today we have Robbie and Peter here from Autosmart. The lads have come to top up the detergent there. So if you don't mind, Robbie, would you maybe show us inside the van? Yes, there,
absolutely.
And just to show the different products there that you have to offer there.
Come on ahead.
You generally call around every couple of weeks there just to top up the few bits there for the lads.
So, yeah, we've a wide range of products. General detergents, alloy wheel cleaners, we have tar and glue removers, heavy duty than your normal ones. We've a really good hand cleaner here, heavy duty hand cleaner. It's environmentally safe and friendly. We also have a wide range of disinfectants and stuff like that. Over on this side here, we have stuff, you know, for dressing the carpets. We have interior dressing. Finish is a good one to you, like yourself, Cathal. I think that's a great product. Leaves a nice back to black shine on the plastics. We also have here tire dressings, and we have all your different types of polishes and waxes. Over here we have some compounds, which is great. AquaSeal Pro is it's a favourite of mine. It's a spray sealant. You spray it over the body of the car. Lasts about 4 to 6 weeks. It acts like a ceramic coating, leaves a beading effect on the paint. Brilliant stuff. Then you have all your general brushes and spray bottles, workshop stuff, very popular recently. We have four different types of detergent. Our premium detergent, which you guys have, which is Actimus, is a great cleaner for agricultural machines, foams well, deep clean, and there's great dilution rates on it. It's the most highly concentrated TFR on the market. We specialise in the more concentrated bulk buys for detergents and so on. And
You have a great range of products there on offer. The ones that we use there are the G101.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a customer favourite now. G101 is highly concentrated. You get great dilution rates out of it, 10 to 1 for general cleaning, 4 to 1 on engines and stuff like that. You can use it. It is a multi-purpose cleaner, and it's called G101 for 101 reasons, 101 solutions.
Okay. That's great stuff. Look, we'd like to thank Robbie here for running through all the different products here he has to offer us, and these boys give a great service here. So if you're looking for any cleaning products there, just give the lads a shout there. That's
perfect,
all.
Yeah, you can find us on Google and, Autosmart Leinster.
So that's it for this Workshop Wednesday. I hope you all enjoyed it there. Sean is just going to put the bits back here on the 6910. We'll have her up and running there shortly. So. There's a whisper, message from a new world I'd never known. Something about it felt like I've been waiting my whole life. Is this home? I can hear Reeves on calling my name. So. Until next Wednesday, take care, we'll see you then.